This little oak plays an important part in a complex, high-end Swiss research project. Together with other trees, it will help scientists understand how climate change is impacting forests and suggest countermeasures. Scientists suspect that air bubbles have formed in the tree's vessels. This phenomenon, called cavitation, leads to embolism, the disruption of water transport in the tree. Cavitation is invisible from the outside, but it can be revealed with this powerful micro CT scanner at EPFL. With this technology, scientists can predict the threshold over which various tree species will not recover from embolism and die. As it turns out, in our oak, the scientists have detected embolism in some vessels only. In comparison, most vessels of this other severely stressed tree are filled with air. These CT images are no big surprise. In the climate chambers at ETH, the scientists had exposed both trees and others to two climatic stress factors, heat and high vapor pressure deficit, or VPD. So what is VPD and why is it important? Let's look at this tree first. In warm weather, a plant transpires, which cools down its leaves. Transpiration occurs because of the atmospheric demand for water. The warmer the air, the more water vapor it can hold. And the more water the air can potentially hold, the higher its vapor pressure deficit, VPD. Simply put, VPD is the difference between the actual amount of moisture in the air and how much moisture the air can hold when it is saturated. To avoid drying out, the tree closes its stomata, the tiny pores through which it loses water. In doing so, the plant cannot absorb CO2, which it needs to grow and survive. Over a longer period of time, the plant risks to starve and eventually to die. So why does VPD matter? A high VPD has a drying effect on plants. With global warming, VPD has increased and is expected to increase further. The amount of water vapor actually present in the atmosphere has not grown at the same rate as global warming. This is partly because evaporation from the oceans has been declining over the last 20 years, for reasons that are still unclear. Therefore, in the future, trees might suffer from atmospheric drought stress just because the temperatures are going up, even in humid tropical climates. Disentangling the effects of VPD from those of other factors, such as heat and drought, is a new challenge for scientists worldwide. This is precisely the overall aim of this project, which is the first of its kind. In six climate chambers, scientists manipulate VPD and temperature while keeping the plants well watered. They investigate the tree's water and carbon uptake. They monitor numerous parameters, such as the photosynthetic activity of the tree, or the negative pressure in the tree's vessels. The amount of pressure needed to make the sap bubble appear in the pressure chamber corresponds to the amount of negative pressure in the leaf. This parameter informs the scientists on the degree of stress the tree is experiencing. At WSL, the scientists measure similar parameters in 16 open-top chambers. Here, they can't control VPD, but they simulate drought and they expose young trees to chronic warming. These conditions correspond to levels predicted for the year 2100 under a business-as-usual scenario. They also monitor the temperature at the surface of the leaves with a thermal camera. In a hot and dry environment, leaves can reach temperatures up to 50 degrees Celsius. These extreme temperatures slow down the functions of trees, which can eventually lead to their death. On a WSL test site in the dry pine forest of Finnwald, 900 trees have been irrigated since 2003, while their neighbors grow in natural, drier conditions. Numerous research projects have been conducted in this open-air lab. Eventually, data from these projects and from the two main experiments will be fed into models in order to predict the reactions of trees to heat, drought, and rising BPD. These models will help recommend more appropriate forest management strategies and select tree species that are less vulnerable to drought, such as, maybe, this young oak.